Here in Rotorua we have a very active geothermal system and we have lots of surface features, and the idea today is we're going to walk around some of those features and just look at the different types and how they interrelate to each other. Geothermal systems are a byproduct of volcanism. So here in Rotorua we have the heat from the volcano underneath us. We have the rain falling in the area, soaking down into the ground, mixing with the heat and then coming back to the surface to provide our geothermal features. Okay, so let's go and explore some of these geothermal features in Rotorua and we'll have a look at some different types. Here we're looking at a classic alkaline chloride pool. This is where our primary geothermal fluids, the same as that we see in the bores at sort of a kilometre or two depth, is basically coming straight to the surface, and we get these really, really hot pools and these lovely crystal clear waters. Typically the temperatures of these alkaline chloride pools will be a near boiling temperature. They'll be in the 80-90 degree C range. Geysers are a special example of our alkaline chloride pools, and that's where they're erupting rather than overflowing or sitting as a stagnant pool, and there's several of those in the Rotorua area. This pool beside me here is an example of the mixed chemistry. This is where our primary geothermal fluid is rising to the surface and mixing with the groundwater, and we get some precipitation of the geothermal fluid into the water, and we get the milkiness and cloudiness. But we do get a real variety of colours and textures in these pools. Sometimes they're blue, sometimes they're green, sometimes they're creams. And we're now going to measure the temperature with the IR gun and see how hot it is. So I'm seeing a temperature around 50, 51 degrees, 53 degrees, which is pretty typical for this type of feature. Here we're looking at a mud pool. This is a classic steam heated feature. Steam is rising from the geothermal system. We have quite a complex chemical reaction with the groundwater and the soil that makes an acid solution. And that acid solution eats away the soil and makes the mud for the pool. These pools often look like they're boiling, but in fact the temperatures will be maybe between sort of 60 and 80 degrees C. Sometimes it's just the gas coming through that gives the appearance of boiling. Yeah, so we're seeing a temperature here that's in the high 60s to low 70s, sort of fluctuating around 70 to 76 degrees C. Another aspect of the geothermal systems is the steam heated warm ground, and this is an example here, and we're just going to take some temperature measurements and see how warm the ground is. So we're seeing 45, 46 degrees here in this clear area. In the areas where we've got steam coming to the surface, we get bare areas like where I'm standing at the moment, and then we get stunted grasses and vegetation growing around the edges and where the ground is cooler. So we have a wide variety of geothermal features here in New Zealand, and especially here in the Rotorua Taupo area. But if you visit other geothermal systems globally, you'll also see the same features.